Hey, what is going on, guys? My name is Zero and welcome back to another top 5 video. Now in this top 5 video we'll be doing the top 5 Black Ops 2 zombie glitches. Now as an experienced glitcher myself back in the day, I did go across a few glitches in my time, and I'm just going to showcase my 5 favorite glitches that I enjoyed doing when playing zombies back in the day of glitching when it was really popular. So before we get anywhere into today's video, be sure to drop a like down below and also subscribe to never miss any Black Ops 3 content in the future. But anyways, let's get straight into today's video. Coming in at my number 5 spot, we have the Mob of the Dead walkway glitch. Now, this is a near electric cherry. Now, to do this glitch, you're just going to come up near the gondola and electric cherry. I'm pretty sure it's in between there over the whatever it is, the blue walkway down below, and you're going to line yourself up just off the edge of this, and you are going to look forward towards the railings and the zombies will pile up there. The reason why this glitch comes in at number 5 is simply because zombies can get you from behind. They come in from towards the gondola and they will actually attack you from behind if you don't have jug or whatever. This glitch is just really easy to use if you need to get a few points to start off the game and whatever, but I don't promote glitching as much as I do anymore. But anyways, let's get straight into my number 4 spot. Coming in at my number 4 spot, we have the buried spawn room glitch with the paralyzer. Now to do this glitch, you're going to obviously need the paralyzer, and you're going to go to the back of the witch's place, you're going to smash those two fountains, and you're going to make your way back to this area, and you're going to earn an achievement as well if you haven't done this before. And what you're going to do is you're going to line yourself up wherever I do. You're going to shoot the paralyzer and you're going to fly up in the air and you're going to land yourself here perfectly, and you'll be completely invincible from all the zombies. Now what I love about this glitch is simply because you cannot get hit, but there are always a downside to a glitch. There's something good that you can't do to it, and you can't get the power-ups. That's the only bad thing about this glitch, but you can go on for rounds and rounds if you've upgraded the paralyzer and you don't mind waiting forever for zombies to spawn. But that's what makes it the number 4 spot. Let's get straight into my number 3 spot. Now for my number 3 spot, we have the buried barrel glitch, which is over by the witch's house and the Vulturade church, whatever. And you're going to have the paralyzer as well for this. Yes, every glitch I'm pretty sure I'm buried requires either the trample steam or the paralyzer in order to do it. You're just going to shoot yourself up in the air. You're going to land yourself exactly where I have. Now the good thing about this glitch is you can kill zombies. Yeah, I don't recommend using any weapon that has a knockback, like the Ray Gun Mark II, as that will knock you out of this glitch and you will get killed by the zombies. But you can just use the paralyzer, you can get power-ups, you can get your ammo back. I recommend having Mule Kick in this glitch, just so you can have some variation between weapons, because you can actually spray your ammo. But anyways, that is in at our number 3 spot. Let's get straight into my number 2 spot. Now for our number 2 spot, we have the Dire Eyes wall glitch. Now this glitch was found by me a very, very long time ago with a few friends as well. We were just playing around and I found this. I didn't upload it on this channel, I believe it was before I got hacked on my other channel. But what you're going to need for this glitch is you're going to need a trample steam, and you're going to place it exactly where I have. You're going to equip whatever weapons and perks you may need, and you're going to hop onto the trample steam and it'll launch you into the wall. Make sure you crouch while you do this as well. No zombies can get you while they're in this glitch, which is pretty good. And you can also get the power-ups. Now, there's only one downside to this. As I said, there's a downside to every glitch, is that the minion things, those jumpy jacks, they can actually spawn through the hole. So they'll try and take you out. Don't shoot the liquefier or whatever. But anyways, let's get straight in to our number 1 spot. Now for our number 1 spot, we have the Nuketown knife lunge glitch, which was found 3 years ago, a few days after Black Ops 2 was come out. So what a thing this is. This is absolutely nostalgic to see this glitch up in action, and it still works. What I loved about this glitch is because on Black Ops we had the knife lunge glitches, and this was also glitched into Black Ops 2 as well. And what you do is you get the zombie on the balcony, on the veranda thing out the front, and you jump onto this thing and you would knife and you would get launched straight into the air and you'd land on top of the map and you were completely invincible. But you'd have to buy the doors and all that in order to not hit a death barrier, and you could explore, you could jump onto the bus, you could jump onto the yellow house, you could jump onto rocks. It was so much fun to do this when it first came out, because knife lunging was so easy. You'd charge up your knife on this, and you just knife lunge, and that's what I love. But anyways, if you enjoyed today's video, please be sure to leave a like down below and also subscribe. And if you have another top 5 for you wanting me to do, leave that in the comments. But anyways, my name is OROHD, and I'll see you all next time. Peace.